Okay, so I feel a little silly now. There was that little passage on the second floor that I just kept missing. But at least we got it in the end. Let's get out of here. Since we're here, we might as well get another Jiggy that's kind of nearby. We're gonna need the running shoes for it, though. So once you step on that switch, it actually activates a grate far away from here. And we're gonna have a limited amount of time to get there before the gate closes again. Running shoes, that should be plenty of time to get there, though. Yay, made it. Slow down, Batman. Now there's something to remember for later. See that rock with Kazooie's face on it? We'll have to come back here later. Here's a place we haven't been to yet. Water storage. Now, if you look on top of that water thing there, you'll notice that there's a Jinjo. Now, unfortunately, we can't get him yet. Because we'll have to go through here from another world. Jolly Roger Lagoon Water. So we'll have to go to a place called Jolly Roger's Lagoon first. Hey, there's the Trouble Clef. The this one. Like, we can climb up and enter. I guess you would call them, like, water silos. Come on, get that Cheeto page. There you go. There should be one more place we can go. It was another mine entrance that we blew up as the detonator. So welcome to the flooded caves. Alright, let's be quick about this. That is not the way I wanted to go. This is another reason that I got the oxygen upgrade before I came here, just so I wouldn't have to worry about this part so much. Ah, there's the Jiggy. Get out of here. Alright, now we can leave the flooded caves. I think we've actually reached the limit of the stuff that we can get from here for now. Yeah. Cause that last Jinjo we're gonna have to go through another world to get, and then to get the last Jiggy we're gonna need to the ability to use the springy step shoes, and that's not gonna be for quite some time. So we're done with Glitter Gulch Mine for now, so time to leave. Let's get out of here. Alrighty, so now that we're done with Glitter Gulch Mine for the time being, we're gonna be heading towards Witchyworld next. Which is another pretty fun world. The management accepts no responsibility for the thieving pickpockets that it employs within Witchyworld. Anyone who rides all the quality attractions and survives is entitled to join the Witchyworld fan club, current club member 0. Witchyworld theme park is currently closed due to an appalling safety record. Once the authorities have been bribed, we will reopen. These signs, man. Anyway, let's take on Witchyworld. So we did come here briefly to learn the split-up ability, but now it's time to actually take on the world. First thing you'll notice here, this lady. Hello there, little darlings. Not personally, but I believe you helped my husband out a while ago when we still lived on Freezy Peak. Mrs. Boggy! How's the big guy? Oh, a little older, a little fatter. He's given up sled racing and taken to watching his new widescreen TV all day. Lazy oaf. Anyway, I must be getting back home. I told my children Groggy, Soggy, and Moggy to meet me here. I don't suppose you feel like rounding them up for me? I guess we could do that, Mrs. B. Wonder if we'll see Boggy soon. I'll just pop it back on the grill, and the punters will never know. Oop, I've been rumbled. So that switch there just opened up the burger joint. What do you do? That gate has to be blown up with grenade eggs. Hey, there's one of the kids. This fair is so much fun. I'm not going back to Mother, and there's nothing you can do to make me. Oh, yeah? Oh, what did you do that for, mister? I'm off to find my mom, and she'll tell my dad. Another two to find. Now, the thing about Mrs.Boggy's kids is that they show up randomly throughout the theme park. So just because I found one of the kids there may not necessarily mean that you'll find one of the kids there as well. They can also appear in several other different areas. There he goes. Just be careful and not touch the high voltage electric fence. I also think it's kind of funny how the enemies here basically just change via which segment of the park they're in. Like, if they're just normal enemies, they look like that. If they're in the space section, they look like aliens. It's funny. And if they're in the horror part, then they look like a Frankenstein monster. Let's climb up this rope. Or not. There we go. Hello, Jinjo! I believe there's a new ability to learn from Jamjars around here somewhere. Just not sure where exactly. What's this? Looking for the kids, you might find them in the Inferno, Star Spinner, Crazy Castle, or the Dodgems. Okay. Now, Mumbo's actually going to have his work cut out for him because there's three locations that we're going to need his magic in this world. Nothing around there. Here's another Jinjo. Ah, there's Jamjars. I passed by him completely. Airborne egg aiming. Shooting eggs defends bird and bear, so why not fire them in the air? Up C gives you the aiming sight, then press Z to shoot from height. But yeah, there's three locations that Mumbo's gonna have to use his magic in this world, so he's definitely gonna get his work cut out for him. Let's head to the opposite side. Actually, first thing we'll do is we'll fight the boss of this world, I think. Now, you need tickets in order to get into the Big Top. I did this earlier when I was collecting some music notes so I could learn the split-up ability. But basically, just destroy those jackpot machines with grenade eggs, and destroying all four will get you the tickets you need. Hey, Conga! I remember you from the first game. You threw oranges at me. Tickets, what do we need them for? Four tickets are required to enter Conga's Big Top. No tickets, no entry. There you go. Cheers, I'd better let you in now then. You're just in time, the show's about to begin. Perhaps we're supposed to sit on this big lump on the ground, on the floor over here? You're telling me, Banjo. What is this? Oh. Oh my. So yeah, say hello to our next boss. Oh dear, not more intruders. Well, I'll show you who's boss. See how big and strong Mr. Patch is. Ah, you're all not all that big, really. That Klungo freak near the start was probably bigger than you. Oh yeah? Well, how about this, then? Mr. Patch, strange, wobbly, inflatable thing. You just had to go and antagonize him, didn't you, Kazooie? I suppose you think you're clever, don't you? Well, one doesn't like to blow one's own trumpet. I sense a battle coming on, if you insist. Alright, so this should be pretty obvious, but his weak point is his patches. Don't! You found a weak spot. It looks like I might need some help here. You'll have to beat me from the air now. So the first one you have to hit him from the ground, but after that you have to start aiming from the air. He has boxing gloves and try to hit you up close. This is actually one of my favorite boss fights in the game. Ow. Okay, that hurt. Ah, get out of my way. Oh, and be careful, because he will spit out beach balls at you. Oh, that got one. It's actually kind of hard to hit him without the homing ability enabled. But they should be locking on. There's another hit. Gonna have to get some more eggs. Ow. The hardest ones to hit are probably the ones on his back. Oops, got back on the ground. I didn't mean to do that. There we go, that got him. Goodbye, Mr. Patch. Uh-oh. Looks like trouble. Fitting way to die, I think. Yeah, the hardest patches to hit are probably the ones on his back. The more patches you hit, the faster he gets as well. But, you know, overall, that's a pretty fun fight. I like it. There we go, first Jiggy of Witchyworld. Let's get out of here. That is not the way out. That's the way out. Ha 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 Okay, let's get our HP back up, because we did get hit a few times in there. Yeah, I suppose I should do this while I'm here. The switch to activate the fry stand is, well, right behind the joint. Aw, sheesh. Someone found the switch. I hate customers. Always wanting things. I think I connect with this guy the most out of all the characters in this game. Hurry up and order, weirdos. I'm a busy guy. So I see, we had to fight our way through this crowd of customers you have. Quite a comedian, huh? Now how about some of Salty Joe's limp salty fries? Oh boy, if that's not a euphemism. Coming right up. Have a nice day, I guess. I'd better start frying up some more, because I'm all out. Yes, you'd better prepare for the impending rush. Why, you cheeky? Salty Joe's Fries, the taste-free, greasy alternative to a decent meal. I love the humor in this game. Now, that tent there actually belongs to Grunty. It's called, like, Madame Grunty's or something. Come inside and have your fortune told by Madame Grunty. However, we are contractually obligated to point out that you may not necessarily like what she decides. Ooh, extra grenade eggs. If you're unlucky, she'll give you a beating and you'll take damage. One of the things, though, is that she can reveal the signposts in Jiggy Wiggy's temple that show, like, the locations of Jiggies and stuff. It's very rare, though. I've never bothered with it, anyway. Big Al's Burgers, 100% meat of rodent origin topped with a synthetic cheese slice. Yummy. And also, he totally just coughed on that burger. Fancy a burger? Big Al sells the tastiest burgers in Witchyworld. How on earth did you get a job in catering? Well, not true, really. I used to clean out the toilets. Go on, give him a try. I've got a few left. Yeah, why not? Okay, kid, burger's coming right up. Too bad, burgers is all I got. Go see Salty Joe. What? I've got no more burgers. Better root around for some more. I think there's one just under your left foot. Gross. So yes, we have lovely carnival burgers and fries. Yummy? Anyway, the first place we're gonna go is the Western World. I see a Jinjo over there. Ring the bell to win a top prize. Now, you're actually supposed to use three different types of attacks in order to ring the bell fully. First thing we need to do is hit it with a grenade egg. Then the bill drill, or drill bill, I keep getting it backwards. Then just a regular ground pound. Ta-da! Easy Jiggy. Alright, let's rescue that Jinjo. There you go, pal. So that's half of the Red Jinjo family rescued. Now Now, there is a gondola ahead of us, and we're gonna try to activate it. There we go. Press B to experience the scenic splendor of the cable car ride across the space zone. Okay, I guess. Well, for the record, there's another pair of boots there that we can't use called the Claw Clamper Boots. But again, that's another ability that we can't use for a long time. Hello, extra honeycomb piece. Okay, good. That made a shock spring pad appear, so we can get up there more easily. There's also a button to push. Now remember in Glitter Gulch Mine there was that box that we helped clear out of the way with the detonator? But now he can get all the way to Witchyworld. So it turns out he's one of the attractions here at Witchyworld, but we can't ride him just yet, because there's no power. The Saucer of Peril is currently closed due to a lack of power, which is, you know, fair enough. We'll just have to come back here once there is power. Get up there. Yep. Blood to you too, buddy. Let's get back over to the Western world. Hey, wait, it's gone. I guess it took off without me. Oh well. Owie. Ow, this shot. Didn't think he'd actually hit me. There are enemies on this side. Alright, we made it to Woomba's Wigwam.